just ask you one question, sir. You allowed this man no opportunity whatsoever.
So? So what?
This is Wrestling Sunday School.
This is John.
This is Dan.
And we are here to talk about the history of pro wrestling, its most exciting and charismatic figures, and its most interesting events. And we're starting off this series with one of our favorite wrestlers. So, Dan, what can you tell us about Bruiser Brody?
Bruiser Brody was a man named Frank Goodish, and he stood about 6'8", 283 pounds in his prime. Fortunately, he died in his prime. Man born in Michigan and found his way down to the Southwest, primarily Texas, West Texas, where the greats of Terry Funk, Tully Blanchard, Dirty Dick Murdoch, Dusty Rhodes, Stan Hansen, Ted DiBiase, Tito Santana, and Barry Windham all came from.
Yeah, it was like a hub of wrestling talent.
Something was in the water there.
But like maybe it was in the football team, because they were all on the football team.
They were all on the football squad, yeah. Most of them were. I think Dusty was a baseball player. But those guys, there was something going on there, there was lightning in a bottle in that area. He came down. He started off in Detroit, Michigan. He hooked up with Ed Farhat, also known as the Sheik.
The Sheik.
Who also trained guys like the likes of Sabu and RVD, who are current wrestling superstars. Or actually, they're almost classics now.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting that the Sheik trained him, because the Sheik had a really brutal style of wrestling. He was known for having really brutal matches. He was kind of like Abdullah the Butcher almost stole his gimmick.
Yeah. Right? And, you know, you can even say that the Sheik was always bloody, and the guys that followed him, or the guys that he trained, followed in the same footsteps. They even say that Bruiser Brody, or King Kong Brody, invented hardcore. Walked out with the chain.
Yeah, always swinging a chain over his head.
Swinging a chain round and round.
Or a 2x4, mm-hmm. And which is interesting to me, because the guy that he trained would pick that up.
Yeah,
and that's Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan. I saw a video with Hacksaw where Hacksaw was talking about something that Brody had mentioned to him about weapons. Bring something to the fight that you can fight with, not a tennis racket.
If ever there was a man who lives, eats, and breathes professional wrestling, it's this man, Bruiser Brody.
You know, Gordon, I want to make sure everybody knows what happened this week. I was contacted by my attorney about coming out here on national TV last week and calling Dusty Rhodes a great big fat overstuffed pig. Well, I want to make sure everybody knows that Dusty Rhodes is a big fat egotistical blowhard. And I don't mean instead of a pig, I mean in addition to a pig.